Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Coker. School enrollments in New Hampshire are down. The question is why. Here are some numbers, and we're going to show you a graph in a minute also, but these numbers come from the State Department of Education. All schools, the 2001-2002 time frame, 230,961. Now, that's public and private schools in New Hampshire. Now look at 2010 and 2011, down to 2012, 816. These are the latest numbers from the New Hampshire Department of Education. With me to talk about this is somebody who is taking a deep look at this subject in New Hampshire, Russell Tebow, who is president of Applied Economic Research. Welcome.
Good to be here,
Fred. Nice to have you back.
Thank you.
We're going to show a graph in a minute, but before we do, what's going on?
Well, basically, you've got school enrollment, as you pointed out, is declining. It's primarily because the kids of the baby boomers are moving out of the school age population and being replaced by smaller class sizes. Births in New Hampshire are down about 1,000 a year, 1,000 fewer kids being born in the state. And also, the state's overall population is not growing as fast as it had been during the 1990s.
Now, let's show a graph you brought with you, and this is from you. And that's just interesting because this shows 1974 on the far left and 2010 on the far right. And look at the bulge about the year 2000, the topmost part of that blue part of the graph. Just describe that.
Well, basically, what you see is enrollment was rising very rapidly during the 1990s because of the opposite of what's happening now. Namely, baby boomers' kids were entering into the school-age population demographic. Now they're graduating, by and large. Right. Most of them are out of the system. So now you have declining enrollment because of this demographic forces, the baby boom kids moving out of elementary school and high schools.
It's interesting that in some of the smaller communities in the state, and let's take Bedford, Hampton, Southampton, so forth, it's the eighth grade. It's the kids below the eighth grade where the reductions in enrollments are occurring in the greatest numbers as opposed to above the eighth grade. So this, I would assume, is going to lead to further declines in enrollments at high school.
It is. The smaller class sizes are moving through the system, and they are starting to have an impact on middle school and high school populations now. So they will be declining
also. And then there's college.
And then down the road is college. Most of the projections of college enrollment show a declining enrollment by virtue of this demographic force.
You know, it's interesting. The one-room schoolhouse that New Hampshire was so famous for, along with other New England states for years, are we going back to that? Do you think we're going to see classes merged, schools closed?
It's very possible in the small districts. The larger districts like Concord, Manchester, Nashua are looking at possibly closing schools. The smaller districts where there's only one school, you don't have that option. And as class sizes shrink, to realize some economies, we may go back to seeing, I don't think we'll get back to a one-room schoolhouse, but maybe some classes combined.
Well, my mother-in-law taught in a one-room schoolhouse in Grantham, so she'd be interested if we go back that way. Just a general economy, New Hampshire, real quick. Where are we?
That's still looking pretty good, Fred. The numbers came out this week nationally showing about almost 250,000 jobs added. The economy is still bouncing along the bottom. New Hampshire's doing better than the rest of the country.
Russ Tebow, president of Applied Economic Research. Thanks a lot.
Great to be here.
You can see this interview again at WMUR.com. Just click on Project Economy.